Sarah Jarrett, so I'm a career advisor here at CBCC. And so today's topic is creating a good resume cover letter. And so, okay, we're messed up. So anyway, I don't have a clicker, so I'm depending on this mouse strapped down. So are you familiar with the resources online that we have? What I wanted to do is kind of highlight, this is our current webpage and where you can find things about career choice, reading up on careers, you know, figuring out kind of where the jobs are, that kind of thing. And so,
yes, you went over this with me when I was in the job.
That's what I was thinking, yes, yes. So, but basically, just as a refresher, go to our main website, go to resources, career center, and then there are these different things you can do here. There's skills, personality assessments, there's the ability for you to research particular jobs and careers, as well as to look for actual job openings. This is how it looks now. Our website is being renovated, and the same information will be there, but it will be in a different and actually a much more usable format within a month. So you'll have to find everything again. But anyway, we'll just kind of go through a couple of things and then we'll play around with some things too. College Central Network, have you activated your account on that yet?
I have not.
Okay, good. That's one thing we'll do while you're here. Okay. And so what this is our online jobs board and career resource center. So basically employers can contact me and post jobs for our students to see, and they go on here. There's also a national jobs database. There's an internships database, as well as all kinds of career documents and information that you can read and listen to and watch kind of 24/7. There's also a resume builder on there. Do you have a resume?
I do.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure it needs to be tweaked.
Okay. Okay, good. So you can either do that the same way you're doing it, or you can go through this resume builder. And so let's go ahead and have you log in. So, it's just you. Okay, so go to resources. Okay. Then open a new. And go to www.collegecentral.com/CDCC. Oh, just go through, and everything that has a red star, you need to answer.
Okay.
And so you just need to activate your account by putting in some basic demographic information.
Asking for like special skills and certifications.
Yeah, let's see. So you don't have to put anything there. And then the other thing is about kind of just giving permission, and basically they're not going to spam you with anything, and I won't either.
Okay, good.
So you're at the dashboard, and so what you can see, and I've got just a screenshot of the dashboard, but over on the right hand side, this is a list of the career documents that are available. And so if you click on those, you can see these little one-page highlights about all kinds of career topics. And I'm going to give you a few examples of those to take home today. But it's very fast, so if you want to just read a quick topic on, say you've got an interview next week, what should I wear? There's one on there, and it's a one-pager. The middle section here has some more, and you may need to save it and open it there in Adobe. Has kind of some more detailed little articles. They control that content. And then over here are videos. So if you're somebody who likes to watch your knowledge, you can watch videos on many career topics. And then there's also podcasts. So if you like to listen to things, or you're at the gym and want something different, you can kind of listen to a lot of this information kind of as you go. So this is kind of your 24/7 career office that you can, you know, utilize easily from home and get all the resources that you need. At the top on yours, there's some announcements, and you can see we've got a transfer fair coming up, which we're also using through the system. On yours, yeah, right here, these alerts. And so there's a transfer fair, and you can look at that, and you can search and see what schools will be there. And then, if you just click begin search, you don't pick anything specific, you'll see the list. So that's who's registered and who's coming so far. And then if you click on the school, you can read about them and learn a little bit more about what they offer. And so the same, and just kind of back buttons. And then the same thing happens with the career fair. And it looks, so click on that one. Yeah. And so this gives you the details about when the career fair is. It's March 28th, 11 to 2. And then you can do the same thing. You can search and see what employers have already registered. And if you just click begin search. So we've got about 10 who've signed on so far. And then you can click on them and read about the job openings and a little bit about each employer. So if you always look at those announcements, it will kind of alert you to things that are coming up, including like the fairs, workshops, that kind of thing.
Okay.
And so on the next side, on the left side there is a, and I don't know if I have a slide about this, is a resume builder. Go back to my screenshot here. And you see where it says My Resumes. So if you were to click on that, then you could simply upload the resume that you already have. And it talks you through that, you know, you look for your file, upload your resume, or you can build a resume. So click on resume builder.
And so what this is like a little fill-in-the-blank way to create a resume. And so you can simply, you can read up on resumes. First thing you do is name your resume. So you could name it by the day or by the function if you have one kind of nursing-oriented resume versus an office assistant resume. You might create a couple of different ones. But you name your resume. Go ahead and name one, just so I can sort of show you how this works. Yeah, just so that you remember what it is. If you want to call it February 2017 or... and then click Build It. And so then, this kind of gives you the different sections for the resume. And if you want to fill in that space, you click the plus. But click the plus on Contact, and it already has it. Because you knows it's you in here. So tell it to add your contact information. And then you've already gotten started on the resume. So same thing, if you were to put in education, you could click that little plus there just so you can see what it looks like. So then you can just fill all of that in. And so just go one page, one section back. But hit preview resume. Okay, tell you what, it wants you to fill in something. Fill in just something fake if you want. Or if you want to put go in your education, just put CBC City or if you have a summary of skills. So I like a bulleted list the best. So put two skills in there, one on each line.
Any skills?
Any skills, like computer skills, a lot of people would put, maybe a character trait that is. Save it onto your flash and you can work on it more or whatever. So, because it, you know, the builder is great, but it does have limitations. So if you wanted like your name to be really big, it won't allow you to do that. But yeah, so once you have it, saved and completed, I guess, and then, because it still has in process. So once you get to the end of it, it'll give you a chance to save it. And then you can click on the name of it right here. Like I said, it'll just boom, open it up for you. So now you can take it off of this, and you don't have to keep going back through here unless you just want to. But if you have a resume on here and you give authorizations once it's completed, then an employer could look at your resume.
Oh, that's really good.
And so
that's, you know, you might want to put do not authorize for now while it's in process. But once you have it complete, you might want them to be able to do that. But that's what College Central looks like, and now you're activated.
Nice,
so you're all set. Yeah, that's kind of why I wanted to be in the computer lab. So I hope I can get a whole bunch of people updated. But let me skip through a few more topics here. So do you feel comfortable about how to use that? I mean, it's very easy, yeah. I think, and user-friendly. I've been really pleased with it. And I know we've met before, so you may have talked about some of this stuff, but you know, the purpose of your resume is really to provide an overview. The resume is what you need to get your foot in the door to the interview. And so you don't want every single thing in your life on the resume, but you need to have something that makes sure you're stand out a little bit. So they may get stacked like that for certain jobs. So you want yours to stand out. If you use the resume builder on College Central, you'll have all the right information and you won't put any of the wrong things down.
Yeah.
There is no spot for you to put things that aren't, you know, professional. A lot of people now are using a summary statement instead of an objective. Really, your objective is to get the job. So it's sort of a waste of space, unless you have a lot of space to fill. But usually, instead, it would be better to probably include some kind of summary. And even on College Central, you can change what you call that. You can make a summary of qualifications. You can make it a summary statement. You could do it in bullets. You could do it as a short couple of sentences. You know, however you feel like would best kind of get the point across that you're trying to make. Usually a resume is one page. If you have 10 or more years of work experience and you need a second page, then that's fine. I would not recommend going over 2 pages at all. But maybe if you're a college professor or, you know, high-level administrator and have more of a CV, but one to two pages is fine. And again, 10 years back is adequate, so you don't have to put every job you've ever had since, you know, you started babysitting at 12 or whatever.
What if I've held like 2, sometimes 3 jobs at a time?
Yeah, I would put them on there, and you would just have...
I think it's pretty lengthy.
Yeah, well, I would think about how relevant they are to the type of job you're trying to get. So if one of them maybe is relevant to your career path, then you put that job down. If they're all relevant or they all just simply show that you have the ability to work and balance a lot of things, you can put them down, but you don't have to put a whole lot of description.
Gotcha.
So, or, you know, sometimes people might be, let's say you were a sales associate and you worked for 3 retail stores. You could potentially do sales associate, and then you could list the company name and date, company name and date, company name and date, and then sort of 3 to 5 bullets of what you did as a sales associate. So you could make it sort of one little bit longer, because if you basically did the same thing, 3 places, sort of about the same time. But yeah, so if it does get long, because yeah, the way you kind of decide what jobs to pull off is as they get older or less relevant, or if they were very short term. You know, if you had one job that you did for 2 years and then you added 2 more jobs in the summer, well, you could not show those summer jobs if you didn't want to. Because if it was a very short term, especially as you get further in your career, those don't really matter so much. But yeah, that's a great question. Obviously, you don't really put anything personal on your resume except your contact information. And you just want to be sure you have adequate white space. If you use the builder, again, it kind of gives you sort of some generous margins. You can change those a little bit. But you just want to be sure that if someone was scanning your resume, that they can get the point of it in about 10 seconds and decide whether to put you in the pile to read, and to decide to put you in the pile to read this one closer. And so you always want to use action words, which I'm going to give you a list of those. So rather than, you know, you want to say accomplish, performed, you know, that would be even how you could start your bullet. Performed cashier functions, you know, for 12 hours a day or whatever, or, you know, whatever you might say specifically, rather than I work as a cashier doing these things. you know, because again, you want a safe space, you want to make it easy to scan. Keywords are important in a resume because sometimes when you apply for a job, and we might have talked about this before, the first look at your resume might be done by a computer program. So if you have, if it's a big employer and you, you know, do all your online application, it's possible that they have their job description and they have their applicants and that the computer does some initial matching and might say, okay, we had 300 applicants for one position, and the hiring manager might say, well, how many are an 80% match? 200. Okay, that's too many. How many are a 90% match? That's 100. Still too many. How many are a 95% match? Okay, that's 30. Okay, I'll look at 30. And so you might be number 33 or 103, and you were a way better match for the job, but because you didn't have enough keywords on your resume, the computer didn't pick you up. And so as you're looking at job descriptions, if there are words on that job description that are true for you, that are not on your resume, you might think about getting them on there. And don't lie, but an easy example is for me, when I applied to work here, this is a state job, and they call this kind of work counseling, right? Where I worked at four-year schools, counseling was mental health counseling, personal counseling came out of the health center. I never would have thought I would work in a counseling office. I'm not a licensed counselor. We call this kind of thing advising, mentoring. And so on my resume, because I wasn't really sure whether a computer looked first or how smart it might be, I changed some words. So sometimes instead of advising, I discussed counseling students on these topics. Or, you know, instead of mentoring, counsel students on, you know, leadership positions or whatever. And so that's something that, because you're never going to know who looks at your resume first, that is something that you could kind of take note of. You could also be sure if the job description mentions very specific computer programs or pieces of equipment or, as a nurse, certain types of skills that they expect you to have. And you have those, put them on that resume. Because then you're more likely to show up as a match for the job that they have open. So sometimes people don't have a lot of work experience. And even if you do, you might, let's say you've done a lot of part-time jobs that really don't have anything to do with nursing, but you were involved in a great big project in a class where you did something very related. You might want to highlight a special, you might want to add a section called projects, where you might even create, you know, this sort of something that you did that was very much related to your career that you did in school, or that shows teamwork or leadership or things like that. And so you can get a little creative depending on, you know, kind of what you need on your resume and what level of experience, you know, you do or don't have. If you're making a career switch, you want to really highlight the skills that are transferable and even say those words, I have transferable skills in this, in your cover letter, which we'll talk about in a minute. But you want to really be able to talk about why you're making the shift, you know, to the new field. I like to say connect the dots of your experience, because an employer won't do it. You might know very well that your work as a server at a restaurant for 5 years makes you well suited to be a front desk receptionist. The employer may or may not make that leap. And so you could then say, look, I'm skilled in customer service. I deal with difficult people and special situations all of the time, and, you know, always keep a smile on my face and make sure people end up happy. And so that's, you know, kind of connecting those dots and those experiences to help an employer see that you are fit for, you know, the position they're trying to fill. Sometimes people have gaps in experience. You can fill that in if you think of back, and you might have some volunteering that you did then, or you might have, you know, done a little internship. Or you may simply, you may have gone back to school. And so again, those things kind of show. And plenty of people now have gaps because the economy at times has just, you know, kind of forced that. So I don't think that's as much of a deal breaker as be conceived. But if you have something that fills it in, great, great to include it. If people have been fired for a job, you just want to be truthful and accurate, never badmouth that employer. You know, you worked there these dates, wasn't a good fit, you know, you've moved on to the next place. But you don't want to, you know, that they can find these things out when they call references. So you don't want to, you don't have to, you don't want to list that you were fired, but you want to, you know, not badmouth them either. So. Okay, so this is just sort of some things if I, well, we hadn't been able to look at College Central just to kind of talk about how you would arrange your resume, but usually, it doesn't really matter whether you put your education or your experience first. I would say you want to put whichever one first is most relevant to the job. So for you, if you go to nursing school is going to probably be your most relevant nurse experience, right?
Yeah.
That you will have had at that point. So you're going to want to put your nursing education there. Then you'll put your jobs underneath. But if someone went to nursing school 20 years ago, and they have worked as a nurse this whole time, now they want to be a nurse supervisor, well, they may be better suited to have their education, their experience showing first. They're going to look at all of it, but you want to catch their eye with whatever is most relevant to the job that you're trying to do. So there's a neat place you can go if you're having trouble with wording your job descriptions. Sometimes, you know, you do a job and you can't think about, well, how did I say what I did? Gosh, I was just a, you know, cashier. I don't, you know how to say everything. This onetonline.org is a very easy place to go. And I will pop on there for a second to show you. I'll show you where you can find it too. It's also on our website. But you don't have to make all this stuff up, which is really, okay, so back to Resources Career Center, and this is under Exploring Career Fields, and it's this ODAT right here. And so, what's a job that you have, Rachel?
I worked as a high school secretary.
Okay, so let's look up secretary. Okay, let's see, so there's a lot of things related to that. So let's go secretaries and administrative assistants.
Yes.
Because you weren't probably an executive, okay. So what this shows right here is on that online, it lists these tasks. And it shows, if you click that little plus like I did, 31 tasks that a secretary typically did. Now, you don't want that on your, that's too much for a resume. But it's a good way to maybe refresh your memory of a job that you did in the past. Maybe you don't have the job description anymore. That's the greatest place to look for how to describe this, is the job description for where you got the job. But you can even look through this, I know it's a little blurry, but you know, it says answer, you might think, it says answer telephones and give information to callers, take messages, or transfer calls to appropriate individuals. Wow, that sounds great. Now, you know you did that. With this program, you can even just highlight, copy, and paste over into your resume or the resume builder. So you could type in, you know, any of the occupations you've had, select some of the bullets that you like, and just throw them back on there. This ODAT is kind of like the gold standard. So this is where a lot of like job descriptions get written from in the first place. So this is kind of the basics. But it's also can be really helpful, you know, prior to an interview, because if somebody wants to talk about, you know, what kind of knowledge skills did you need to work in a school as a school secretary, well, here's a section on knowledge. You know, even just to remind yourself, refresh your memory about some of the things that you probably were doing and learning. And so it kind of goes on, and the pluses will expand it. This is a big, big job with a lot of areas. So and you can read, you know, more about it. But you can also use this to read more about a job. So if there's a job you want, and you want to know, okay, well, what, is there anything else I need to know about that? Type in nurse supervisor, or nurse manager, or whatever, and see what comes up. So it's a pretty nice, helpful site, I think. But that's the Unknown Online. Okay, we already went over how to use the resume builder, so. All right, any questions about resumes? I'm gonna give you a couple of examples before we go, but if you've already got one, you know, you're in a great, great place. How about cover letter? Do you have cover letters? Do you do cover letters? Okay. Most job descriptions, a lot of times they'll say, send a resume to this place, right? Attach a resume. If you attach a cover letter, you'll stand out above the crowd because most people don't. They're kind of a pain in the neck. They have to be pretty specialized for the job you're trying to apply for. And most people just don't do them. So if you do one and you do a nice one, it'll be a positive for you. And so as I mentioned before about kind of connecting those dots, you know, your cover letter is where you can kind of do that. So you might say something like, you know, X number of years, you know, as a school secretary, I decided to return to school to pursue my passion of becoming a nurse. And so I'm currently, you know, attending pre-nursing program at CBCC. I will be going on to Central School of Nursing starting in the fall. And I'm looking now to gain some part-time employment in a medical setting. And so there, right there, boom, you've just kind of connected some dots because they might look at your resume, they might see, oh, school secretary, administrative support. Why the leap to a medical office, which you know you could totally do, but you need to spell out to them how it now reflects, you know, your current plan and your current interests. It also gives you a chance to kind of show an employer how enthusiastic you are about the position. So you can kind of put a little more personality into the cover letter than you can the resume. Your resume is pretty static, you know, there's some different ways you can do it, but you're not very creative in a resume. But in a cover letter, you could come up with something that really kind of stands out and they make someone want to read your resume. So one page should be plenty for any cover letter. The more you can match their needs to your skills, the better. Sometimes I will see people, you'll see a job description and they'll list certain bullet points that they're looking for in a person. Some people will do a cover letter that will kind of match it up point by point. You know, you're looking for this, here's how I have that. You're looking for this, I've got that. Again, you know, the more tailored it is, the more they know that you planned. You're not just sending this generic cover letter to 100 employers, but you don't want to be too cutesy or too verbose, somewhere kind of right in the middle. Same with the action words and kind of the logical sequencing. I think I have a video. Okay, so let's see if this will work. I thought this was pretty cute.
Jobs.
Okay, so I got that from Monster. Monster.com, and I thought it was pretty cute. But basically, they were kind of breaking down. You know, you have your normal salutation. You want to show that you've researched them a little bit, you know, a little bit about the company, about the job, where you found out about it. Show them that you're the perfect candidate for the job. And then when you get it done, then review it again and be sure that you're conveying the right message. But you overall want to convey excitement and enthusiasm about it, show how you're a great fit, and make them want to read your resume. That is really the purpose of the cover letter, is to get them to read your resume and then to invite you for an interview. You don't need to have everything there. You still need some things to talk about in the interview, right? So you don't want to put it all in your resume and all in your cover letter, but you want to put enough in there to make them say, she looks like she might be good. Let's talk to her. Okay, so customize we talked about. Sometimes this can be a great place. You know, is there something that makes you particularly qualified? Maybe it's not a skill. Maybe it's more something about your personality. Maybe you broke your arm when you were 6 years old, and your best memory of that was the nurse who took care of you when you were waiting to get your cast put on. And that has always been in the back of your mind as something you wanted to do to help someone else. You know, that's not on your resume. That might even just be simply a childhood motivator. But it's a cute little story that could fit into a cover letter and certainly into an interview as well. At the end, of course, you want to thank them for considering you. You want to talk about follow-up. You could offer to follow up with them soon. Okay, so I've got a sample cover letter which I have a copy for you, so I won't worry about going to the website here. But again, this is just more ways of saying kind of the same thing, different, you know, sort of, this is kind of a quick and short one, sort of greet them, open, grab them in, highlight your skills, give a little recap. And unfortunately, there's not a cover letter builder, because that is going to have to be personal to you. Right. You know, I would not help a student in a particular major, might not even need computers much. Well, he wouldn't write a cover letter if he's going for an HVAC job the same way I would write a cover letter as an educator. So, you know, it needs to be your own voice, it needs to be your own personality. And so that's why there is no cover letter builder. You can find samples though. So if you're just not sure, you could Google sample cover letters for a particular field. But in general, so any questions, I guess, about cover letters? Just sort of, you don't have one, right? So that would be a new thing for you to work on. Okay. And if you want to write one and you want to send it to me, I'd be happy to review it and give you some thoughts back.
Oh, really?
Yes. So I'll do that with your resume, cover letter. I can do it over email, you can do it in person, or you can drop it off, pick it up, whatever. So I do plenty of that. But whenever you're sending a resume and a cover letter to an employer, you want to always do it in a PDF format. And now it's very easy on Microsoft Word. You can simply save as and select PDF. But if you do that, then all of your hard work formatting this beautiful resume will never be lost. When you send it to the employer, it will look exactly like it did when you had it on your desktop, and it will not be changeable.
Yes, because you put in through Google, it changes.
Yes. See, I don't know. And see, in the old days, we had like Microsoft Word and Word Perfect, and they didn't really talk very well. And then like on Mac computers and PCs, you know, you might have done it in the same program, but it lost some of your formatting. And with a resume, there's a lot of formatting. There's tabs, there's spacing, and you want it to stay that way. So if you just save it as a PDF before you send it, you can't really edit it very easily in a PDF. It'd be easier to, so you want to have both your Word copy and your PDF copy, but have the PDF one be the one that you attach to an email. Usually you would save them as a separate document, but also sometimes you run into a situation where you can only upload one thing. Have an additional document that's a cover letter dot resume, and you've got them all in one document. Again, saved as a PDF, so if you're only allowed to upload one thing, they get it all from you. You're not having to decide, oh, well, I want some cover letter. And I think just, again, to reiterate, cover letters are not effective if they are not customized. So if you do one, you know, you can have sort of some set paragraphs that you have basically the same, maybe about your skills, your enthusiasm, but you want to mention them probably another time or two, your connection to that exact job, you know, that's going to need to change. But again, most people don't bother to do it, so if you do, you'll be way ahead of the game. So you've just already activated your College Central Network account, so you are doing great. I appreciate that. I do have, as you know, I think, a little career corner over near my office. So if you want to come work on a resume, or if you want a quiet place to apply for some jobs, I've got a computer with a printer right there, and I'm right there, and I can help you with any of that. So it's a good, convenient place. I've got a few more hot topics planned. Another one in about a month to get people ready to go to the career fair. Then a couple more after that as people are starting to look at graduation and summer jobs. But I definitely would like you to make plans to come to the career fair on March 28th. Even though you're planning to go to nursing school next, you're going to need a job after that. And so this is a great time, and I really want to try to promote both the networking and the applying for jobs. Because you could go ahead and start networking with some of the healthcare providers in our area who attend and know that you're going to be on the job hunt in a couple of years. You meet them at a career fair that we have, then let's say you're in nursing school, they have a career fair, you meet them again, remind them you met them at CDCC, they might very well remember you. Then all of a sudden, 2 years down the road, you apply for a job, you took their card at our career fair, you shoot them an email. Hey, by the way, I'm graduating from nursing school now. We first met at CDCC, we've seen each other a few times, I've just applied for this job. Then they might be somebody who says, hey, let's pull Rachel's file out and look at that. You know, I've been talking to her for a couple of years. And so that's kind of the value of going ahead and going to a career fair, even if you're not really ready for a job yet. Because you will be sometime. And the employers are looking to do both things. They're looking to fill immediate positions, but also to look kind of long-term for the future. So hopefully you can, you know, pop over for that next month. So I think that is it. I think I have something. No, okay. But I've got some copies to give you. These are some things about the resume builder, which you already did, but on the back are some more resume tips.